Hey, this is Papa from StreetFighterTrainingSystem.com. Alright, so today we are at day 5 of the bootcamp. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna do like every single day. We take the chart, we review it, we try to draw a market structure, and then we will take a look at some of the trades, how to avoid them, see if they are good trades or bad trades, okay? So first thing is what I want to remind. Okay, so there is kind of three phases. Number one phase is that you need to learn how to count fail to leg pullback. So go into your chart, try to count them all. Okay. Number two is take a look at the dashboard. Okay. And then what you will see is that if you want to have a higher probability rate, you need to have at least two out of five on the Papa score. Okay. And the parameter that has the highest weight is good candlestick early in the party. Okay, and with the trend, of course. So with the trend, good candlestick early in the party. Good candlestick is the major one. Okay, so if you don't have good candlestick, just don't take the trade. Okay, so this is it. So you will train this, then you will filter out with this, right? So this should yield you, if you do only this, you should be around 80% win rate already, right? Which is very good. But now, what I want you to train you, right? Where 80% is good and you can go with it. But the idea of this bootcamp is to master from end to end every single thing and to have maybe 90, 95, 100% win rate. Okay? Well, it's gonna be very difficult to maintain 100% over time. But I think it's feasible to reach 90%. And the only way to do it is to understand market structure. Okay, so market structure, I repeat, is just for you to draw the impulsive move, to draw the reload, and to draw when there is a range. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is that I'm gonna show you again, and I'm gonna do it every day until it goes into your mind and until I see it on every single chart. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna screenshot this, okay, and I'm gonna start drawing the impulsive move. So the market starts over here. So our count, now we should start here, right? So we had one push. So I don't like this color, sorry. So red is reserved for my reload. So I'm gonna take lime, right? So lime will be my impulse. One, two, but this two, you see, it does an equal high, right, than the previous one. The candle doesn't break higher than this one. So this, I call it a failed impulse. So failed two, okay? And usually when I have a failed two, what I will draw is I will draw, so a failed, not a failed two, it can be a failed three, a failed four, or failed five. I will draw the horizontal line, right? So I will draw the channel. So let's see. I'm first gonna draw all the impulse and then we'll see how to draw the horizontal channel. So three, okay, so this is a three. And then after I have an impulse move on the downside. So one, two. Here we have something called a reload pattern. Okay, so I will count, I will show it later on. But if I have a reload, then I start back the count at one. Okay, bon, let me draw it actually, because if not, you're gonna get confused on why I'm starting back at one. So do this. So a reload. Watch my video on reload. So how to know that we are not late to the party? I've done a YouTube video on it. You go and check it. So one, two, three, four, five. Okay. So this means that the party restarts. Okay. So we call it a reload. So this we can start back counting to one. Okay, so I take my lime, I do this. So first impulse, one, two. Here you have a three, but what is this three? It's a failed, right? Because this candle is not closing below the previous candle, so it's a F3. Okay, and then you even have a four over here. Okay. So usually after four, what you want to do is to look for reversal. Okay, but anyway, now we are just counting impulse because we need just market structure. So one, two. Okay. And then here it's shopping, right? It's doing shop, shop, shop. So it's trying to do an impulse, but here I wouldn't even count it as a fail, right? It's just sideways. So the real impulse is this. Okay, three. Okay, so you have the market, kind of the market structure for impulse and reload. Now, as I said, you need to add the particular part, which is the range. Okay, and you can draw a range when you see a failed move, right? So I forgot to draw this one also. So here we have a small impulse over here, which is kind of a failed tree. Okay. So, hop, I change color. My channel, I like to draw it in a fuchsia mode. So I said we can draw a range whenever we see F, we will draw a range. Okay, so here we connect the highs with the highs. Right, up. Then here I have a two and I have a failed tree. I connect it. Here I have a two and I have a failed tree. I connect it. Right. And here what we see, so this market structure is interesting because we have a failed tree. You see this channel, it does a false breakout. It break and then comes back. Right. So when you have this, what you are looking for is either a higher low or a failed to legged pullback. Anyway, and then this. You can see that here it's ranging. You don't have a fail over here. That's why we could have counted this as a fail, right? But you can clearly see that here it's in a range. And when you are in a range, okay, what you want. So let's say that here you had a setup. You don't want to take a setup over here to go long because you don't want to long on the high. Want to long from the low, or you want to sell from the high of the range. That's why it's very important to also draw your range to understand from where are you buying and from where are you shorting, okay, long or short. So now that you have your market structure, so this is good, okay. Now you can analyze what is happening within your market structure, okay. So I want to, before I talk to this, so I will keep this screenshot below. I want to talk about a setup that happened pre-market because I saw someone post on Facebook that he took this trade. Okay, so it was Shoryu Panish, and then he took this trade over here. I think, yeah. So is it a good trade to take or not? So first, my opinion is that we should not play pre-market because the volume is so low that we don't know. If I don't know for now if the probability of stuff happening pre-market is good or not, we can maybe backtest it. It can be part of the backtest, but for now, I don't have statistics on it, so I wouldn't play it. But anyway, let's say he played this move. Okay, so do you think it's a good move or not? So again, to understand if it's a good move, you need to understand a little bit of market structure. Okay, so what should you see when you see this? You should see that there is a lot of candles, okay, that are bouncing out of this level. So you are in a range, okay, you are in a range over here. You have this range, so let me draw it. Hop, basically, the candle, right, are bouncing out of this low, right? So one time, two time, three time, four time, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11. And what did I say? When you are in a range and that it tested multiple times, you don't want to short against this, right? Because you don't know if it's going to bounce again up, if it's going to come back or not, right? So you shouldn't take this trade, and you should see when you have this that the price has basically bounced multiple times. So if there is a trade to take, I will maybe go for the long, meaning this one, okay? Because up, down, up. Down, okay, that happened over here. So this one, right? But I will never go for this failed to get pulled back. It's too risky, right? Even this one, I don't think I will. Actually, it's not even because it's doing a reset. So sorry. So you cannot take trades over here. It's pretty much clear. But yeah, when you see this, so what did you have? First, you had the train against you. You had multiple bounds. So never you should go short over here, okay? So don't go short. So I want to talk about other trades because I think that, and I saw when I was on Discord, some people got trapped over here. So how to avoid this trap, right? So the idea is when you have something, you need to have the market structure. The market structure would have showed you if we go back on the chart, on the screenshot, okay? We see here, we had the 1, 2. So now you have to draw your channel, right? So when you draw this channel, you had the impulsive move. Here, when you have this move, the first thing that you should see is when you will be doing a long, okay? You will be doing a long right into like a channel. And then second, you need to draw your short-term trend line. So your short-term trend line is what? It's this, okay? So your short-term trend line is acting as opposition right into your two-legged pullback. So that is the key mistake that 95% of the people that are on Discord are doing because they are not respecting the short-term trend line. If you want to take two-legged pullback, okay, the number one thing to draw is this opposing short-term trend line. Okay, so I don't want to do a video on it again, and I don't want to spend too much time, but what you need to wait when you have a two-legged pullback move, right? So you need the price first to break from your upper short-term trend line, right? So, and then once it did, you need to draw the opposing. And the opposing is this. And if the opposing is right into your entry point, you don't take it, right? What needs to happen is that the opposing should be like this, and you can take the trade because the opposing short-term trend line will not act as resistance. But this makes a perfect trap because what you want to do, and that's why I call it show you punish, is you want to punish people that are doing and don't understand the price action. They think that they can go long over here, but they cannot because the short-term trend line is acting as resistance. And those are the best, in my opinion, those are the best trap to take. And we can see once it go down, you see how the price like went down. It's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 points. And so it's fairly easy to spot this. It's just you need to draw market structure, have short-term trend line, and so on. One way to do it, what I used to do before, right? I used to look at Discord and used to look at all the mistakes of every single one. And the common pattern is that every single time people were going long because they were not respecting short-term trend line and getting trapped. And this is how I came up with my signature move, which is having a two-legged pull, a failed two-legged pullback that happened inside the short-term trend, the opposing short-term trend line. And this is like almost a guaranteed 100% win rate. When you see this, it's yeah, you have to take this. Anyway, so very good move on this one. I will take it all day, every day, okay? On this one, as I was saying, so here, what you want also, so you have impulse, so first impulse, second impulse, the impulse fail. So here you can see the candle is good. You are with the trend, it's still early in the party, enfin, still early because it's the second impulse, but the problem of this is the room, right? The room between the high and your candle, bon, it's not very good. What you need is to have more room between this high, right? So it worked and it did the 1 point. And look at where it stopped. It stopped exactly, right, at the point where the candle are closing. So this show you, yeah, you could have expected, but you shouldn't expect more than this type of trade. So you can take it. Me, honestly, I will never take those type of trade, but yeah. It won, it's okay, we can understand it. Good candle with the trend. You have 1 point scalp room, but honestly, it's very aggressive, so I wouldn't take this type of trade. Okay, so another one that I would maybe wanted to talk about. So, this one, how you can filter this one. So, as we said, the most important factor is the candlestick. And this candlestick is fucked up. I call it the fucked up hammer, by the way. So when you see this, it's not closing on its top 25%, so you should not take trade when you see this type of candle, okay? Enfin, you should not take. It's up to you, but the probability says that if you take it with bad candle, so bad candlestick as a reminder, so if we zoom a little bit, so you have a 66% win rate if you take bad candlestick. If you take good candlestick, 85%. So where do you want to play? Do you want to play with good candlestick or bad candlestick? I'll let you think about it. The last trade that I want to talk about is this one. And rightfully, like Dean has put a comment on this. So yesterday, I finished work at around 11 p.m., came back home. And then one of the problem, right, is, and also I want to say to you, is don't trade if you're tired. Because if you're tired, you're gonna make mistakes. And it's what I've done yesterday. So the trade worked, but it was not the setup that I was expecting. So here we have up, down, up, down. For those who follow me, I told you that this type of candle, so it's a spinning candle, right? A spinning type candle. So it's something with a huge wick like this, a body on the middle, and then another wick, okay? Is this thing, right? So the thing is, what we want to do is we want to draw like and we want to have something called the ABCD move, and we want to wait for the E to be this candle, and if it is, we want to place a buy stop above this candle, and we'll call it the spinning bird kick, so the SBK, right? But here what happened is the thing did a low, and this, the signal bar is not the spinning bar. But what I did yesterday is that I thought, so I don't know what happened in my mind, I thought that it was a SBK, but no. But anyway, if you still had to play this move, okay, this candle is really, really big. And usually when those type of candles are big, you don't want to place a buy stop above this thing, because I'll just read the comment of Mr. Dean, because at the end, he's telling exactly what I think, right? So what he says is that this setup, it has 4 out of 5 on the Papa score, meaning it has like, it's with the trend, it's early in the party, it's a good candlestick, right? Yeah, so 4 out of 5, but still this trade would have failed because it went higher and then it hit our stop loss. Okay, so why you shouldn't take this? The reason is the way we play failed to legged pullback. We're not playing like everyone else, right? Where we put our buy stop above the candle and we put our low over here. What he's saying is often when we have a bearish bullish setup, the thing is, since we are doing a 2-point stop loss and a 1-point fix reward, placing a buy stop when we have this type of setup that are doing equal highs like this, the price will, 80% of the time, it will come back and it will hit our stop loss. So the idea is, if you see this, it's better to place like either what he's saying, a limit order on the middle of the candle and see if it goes over there and then shoots up. And if it shoots up without you, you shouldn't take it. And as he say rightfully, if it shoots up, it shoots up, and you will have zero money, but it's still better than having minus $100, okay? So, yeah, be careful on this. Me on my side, what I saw, okay? I will tell you what I saw when I was live, and I took this trade with my real account. I saw this spinning bird kick. I saw it doing a low, and then what I did is that I placed a buy stop above, just above here. Okay, and then I got filled and then it worked. Okay, and the same setup happened just after. So I don't say that this is a good setup, by the way. As I said, it's a fucked up read that I've done, but maybe it's a thing. If we have like something that breaks lower with this type of candle before, then we can maybe place a buy stop and it will work. But I don't know, right? I haven't seen the probability. So you should take it on sim, look at the probability of it, but not live, okay? The same setup happened over here where we had, so also what I want to precise is, I want to do precision on what I call ABCDE. So So to give some terminology on what is what, right? Because it's fairly difficult if I say up down up down. So when I have a move like this, this is user fail to leg pullback. Okay, so you have A, B, C, D, E. Okay, what you want is for the spinning butt kick to happen on the E, right? This should be the signal bar. But what is happening now is that the spinning bar is happening on D. So here what happened is that it break lower, and what I think, maybe we can try, again, I repeat, I haven't checked the probability, but if it check, if it breaks lower, okay, you see it live, place a buy stop here and see what's happening, okay? I'm not sure of the winning rate, but this is what I've done. So two times yesterday, it break lower, I placed a buy stop over here, and I look it shoot up, okay? So here, you are playing a little bit with your luck. It's with the trend. I'm not sure on what you should do. Just try it out and give me some feedback, okay? Last thing, so to finish the week. So this weekend, I will not be doing videos, but I will complete, I think, this thing. I will go into February data, maybe March data, to add and see if it is consistent in time. I will also correct some of the stuff that other people has been doing. So Gabriel has been doing stuff. I will include it and correct it before it appears over here. My advice for you guys is do the same. Spend your weekend. So also, if you are following the bootcamp, don't start with the third video, right? Start with the first video on the YouTube channel on the bootcamp. Okay, you don't want to start with the last video. If not, you will not understand anything. And also, the prerequisite is for you to have taken my three lessons before you can understand this, because I'm talking about with the trend, early in the party, and so on. You will not understand anything if you haven't taken the basic lesson 1, 2, and 3. So the order is take the lesson 1, 2, 3. Then you can look at the video called when do we have a restart on the party, which I call reload. Okay, so it's a FAQ. This one, right? Where I tell you the probability. So I think that in the entire universe, you will never find someone showing you like Markov probability and binomial tree to understand why you shouldn't go late to the party. So take a look at this video, because I think it's a very, very, very important video to understand. And why also it will show you why market structure is very important. So once you have done this, okay, you go into your chart and you try to draw market structure, you try to draw fail to get pullback, and you try to understand what works and what doesn't work. And you do like other people. So let's see, there is some new people coming in. Okay, so what they're doing, they're posting their chart and they're telling, okay, I've taken this. They try to analyze on their own. And then there is some people on the chat that will correct them, right? One guy, which is an exception, which I do like, so David. So he's doing something different, right? I think that, speaking a little bit with him, I think he has like a mentor, Al Brooks. So I've never really seen all the video of Al Brooks, but I think that his way of trading is really, really good. It's concise, and I like this comment. So don't hesitate also if you have new way of showing stuff on how stuff can work, just show it. Don't hesitate. I mean, we are here in the community, we are here to learn. I don't pretend to know anything. I don't pretend that my technique is the best one, and I'm willing to learn from others. So yeah, if you have some ideas on how to play in a different way, fail to leg pullback. So this is using like pure price action. Just go ahead and post it. It will benefit everyone. So I do like this guy, and I hope he will keep posting on the chat because it's very interesting. So that's it for the day. I wish you a good weekend, and I'll see you next week. This was Papa from StreetFighterTradingSystem.com.